This is a demonstration of using the NVH app's Unlisted Vehicle feature to set up the app to help you diagnose vibrations on your vehicle. The first thing you need to do after starting the app is agree that you will not drive the vehicle and try to use this app at the same time. It needs to be done by a passenger in the vehicle. So click Agree. Next, we will be selecting Unlisted Vehicle, but what I want to explain is that you would only go to Unlisted Vehicle if you first went to pick your vehicle, so let's do that, and your vehicle manufacturer is not listed here, or when you do click on that vehicle manufacturer, the model year or model that you're looking for is not listed there. So notice there's a not listed menu item there in red text. That will take you to the same place as if we go back one screen and select Unlisted Vehicle. Now, by picking Unlisted Vehicle, there's a lot of information that you have to enter about your vehicle before the app is ready to diagnose vibrations, but there are help files with information to help you find all of that information. So, the first thing you need to find out is what type of powertrain does your vehicle have? Is it front-wheel drive, rear-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, all-wheel drive? Is it one of the newer crossover all-wheel drives or four-wheel drives? If you don't know what any of that means, then click the Help button in the upper right-hand corner and read about the different powertrain types and example vehicles. Once you've got that figured out, come back to this screen and select the one that you want. The one that we are going to use in this example is the very bottom one, a crossover all-wheel drive vehicle. So we will select that. Now, the next screen that we see here is the vehicle information screen, and there's a lot of information we have to enter here. The first thing is the number of cylinders or pistons in your engine. If you're not sure how many that you have, then click the question mark button in the bottom left corner of the screen, and it brings up a help file, and notice the second item that you can pick on the help file is how to determine the number of cylinders or pistons in your vehicle's engine. So read that information, go back to the Unlisted Vehicle screen and punch in how many cylinders are in your engine. Well, in our example vehicle, we have 6 cylinders. All right, the next piece of information we need to enter in the app is the front axle gear ratio. If you don't know what your front axle gear ratio is, which most people would not, then click Find My Axle Gear Ratios right there in the center of the screen. Find My Axle Gear Ratios, and it brings up a help file that tells you how to find your axle gear ratio depending on your vehicle brand. If your vehicle brand is not listed there, then you'll have to search the internet or your owner's manual or where, or someplace else to try to find your gear ratios. But in this case, we are going to use a Toyota vehicle as an example. So let's go clear down to the bottom and select Toyota. Now, the next thing you'll need to select is the model year, but before you select the model year, there's a couple of things you need to know about how Toyota identifies their vehicles and how you can determine what gear ratios and transmission you have in your Toyota. So at the very top of the screen, it tells us that there are 2 possible gear ratios on some all-wheel drive Toyota vehicles referred to as crossover SUVs. Well, that's the vehicle that we are doing the example on here. The NVH app needs both gear ratios to calculate potential crossover SUV vibrations. So the NVH app needs the rear axle gear ratio that is not found on the vehicle certification label on your car. It also needs the front axle gear ratio that is found on the vehicle certification label. So we're trying to find the front axle gear ratio first. So we need to find the vehicle certification label, which is typically attached to the door latch edge of the driver's side door. So let's click the link right there, vehicle certification label, and it brings up a help file with a photograph of what a vehicle certification label can look like. Sometimes they're black with white text, sometimes they're white with black text, or silver with black text. Just find a label on your driver's doorpost that looks something like this. And then if we zoom in here a little bit, we need to know what's called a model code. So outlined in yellow here is the model code of the vehicle that this photograph was taken from, the USK56L-CRTLKA. That is the model code. You are going to need to write that down to be able to find your gear ratios on this vehicle. The other piece of information on this label is what transmission your vehicle has. And that's outlined in red, and in this example, it is an AB60F. So once you've got your model code, we can go back one screen by using the back arrow at the bottom of the screen there. And let's select the model year of this vehicle. In this case, we are going with a 2007, and then we are going to go with a Toyota RAV4. So now it brings up a list of Toyota RAV4s sorted by their model code from that label we just showed you. So you find your model code in that center column there. Our model code is that second one down in the center, the GSA33L-ANAXKA, where it has a front axle gear ratio of 3.080, so I'm going to write that down, 3.080. It also tells us the rear axle gear ratio is 2.277. So now we can go back, we can hit done, and at the front axle gear ratio we can punch in 3.080. At the rear axle gear ratio we can punch in 2.277. So there's three pieces of information that the app needs. The next thing we need to find are the transmission gear ratios. So there's a link right here in the center of the screen. We'll click on that, and that will take us to the transmission gear ratio input screen. And there are two basic types of transmissions that this NVH app supports. Non-continuously variable transmissions, like regular automatic transmissions and manual transmissions, or if we click on CVT up here, continuously variable transmissions. So some vehicles like Subarus and Nissans and various models of other makes and brands have a continuously variable transmission. And if you have one of those, then you'll click on that CVT help button and it'll help you find your low transgear ratio and your high transgear ratio. But in this case, the RAV4 does not have a CVT. And how do I know that? Well, we are going to have to click on Find My Transmission Gear Ratios right there towards the top of the page. So we'll click on Find My Transmission Gear Ratios. Once again, we will scroll down to the bottom there and click on Toyota, and then we will click on 2007, then we'll find the RAV4, and now if we go halfway down the page, we have transmission gear ratios. Select your transaxle model to view the gear ratios needed by the NVH app. Well, so we've got the model codes here in that somewhat center column. Notice ours was the second one down again, the GSA33L-ANAXKA, and it has a transmission model of a U151F. So that's the second one down. I'm going to click on that, and that will take us to a transmission gear ratio page. So notice at the top of the page here, we have 5-speed automatic transmissions. So that tells us our transmission is a 5-speed, and we'll need to know that. And then we have a U151F transmission model, which is the second one down. And notice there are five columns going across there. Those are the gear ratios for first, second, third, fourth, and fifth gears. So you are going to need to write down those gear ratios. The 4.235 is first gear. The 2.360 is second. The 1.517 is third. 1.047 is fourth. And 0.756 is fifth. Once you've got those written down, come back to our transmission gear ratios page, and we need to enter those gear ratios. Now notice here that towards the top of the page, there's a number of gears option. Notice we can hit the plus button if we have a 6-speed, a 7-speed, 8, 9, 10, doesn't matter. This supports clear up to 18 speeds and down to as low as 3 speeds. Well, we have a 5-speed, so let's go back down to a 5 here. And we're just going to enter those gear ratios we just got from the help file. So we have a 4.235 for first gear. We have a 2.360 for second. We have a 1.517 for third. We have a 1.047 for fourth, and a 0.756 for fifth gear. So the app needs these gear ratios in order to calculate your engine speed, in order to calculate which vibrations are normal and which ones are abnormal from your engine. So now we will hit the back button at the top left of the screen, and we're down to just a few pieces of information at the bottom of the screen. There's a question that asks, are your front and rear tires the same size? Now on most vehicles, yes, they're the same size, and by default, yes is selected. But there are some vehicles that have different size tires in the front versus the rear. A lot of sports cars, medium duty, heavy duty trucks have different size front and rear tires. If you had a sports car or one of those trucks, you would select no, and you would have to enter the tire information for both the front and the rear tires. But in this case, on the RAV4, all four tires are the same size. And if you're not sure what size tire you have, notice at the bottom of the screen there is a How Do I Find My Tire Size help file. And it opens up the help file, tells you to look on the side of your tire where the tire sizes are molded in, and you're going to find some numbers, and then come back and enter those numbers into the NVH app. Also, if you just simply don't know or you can't find your tire size molded in the tire, then you can take a measuring stick and just measure how tall the tire is. That's the diameter of the tire. So there's two ways that you can enter your tire size. So let's hit done and come back to the vehicle information screen here. We can either go to the bottom right here and enter the tire diameter, or you can just punch in your tire size. Now the tire size on this RAV4 is a 215, so it's 215 millimeters wide, and then it has a 70 for the aspect ratio, and then 16 inch tire. So finally, and that was a lot of stuff to enter there, but that's all needed by the app to diagnose vibrations on your vehicle. So we have entered cylinders, front and rear gear ratio, transmission gear ratios, and tire size. Now we are ready to press start in the upper right hand corner of the screen. So I will hit start. Now we're presented with the vehicle view screen, where we're looking at a top view of a vehicle outline, where we have the tires, the front engine and transaxle, the rear propeller shaft or drive shaft going to the rear axle on this crossover SUV, and we have the tire sizes on the right hand side, the tire speeds on the left, engine speed at the top, vehicle speed in the middle, and drive shaft speed at the back. So now you are all ready to press start recording and go on your road test, where you will just simply drive the vehicle until it starts vibrating. When the vehicle is vibrating and you have your iPhone or iPad sitting on something hard, no carpet, no seats, nothing padded, it's got to be against something solid like the window or the dash, a console. When it detects that something is vibrating, then the parts that are vibrating will start glowing red on this powertrain outline. So that if the tires are vibrating, they will start glowing red. If the engine's vibrating, it'll glow red. If the drive shaft is vibrating, it'll glow red, and so on. When you're done, you'll just hit stop recording, and the NVH app will tell you what it has detected as the primary source of the vibration on your road test. And we will have a separate video on road testing the vehicle and going through and determining what is the source of the vibration. But you can't even road test the vehicle until you've set up the app for your vehicle. There are two ways to do that. We just showed you the unlisted vehicle method, and then there's the pick your vehicle method that is much quicker if your vehicle happens to be in that list. But not all vehicles are on that list or will be on that list. So this has been a demonstration of using the unlisted vehicle feature to set up the NVH app to diagnose vibrations on your vehicle.